Hello, everybody. In this video, I will show you one of the modernization features of clang-tidy. We will learn about C++ 11's range-based for loops and how to modernize your C++ codebase by letting clang-tidy automate the migration from old-style for loops. There is a saying that goes like, there are only two hard things in computer science. Cache invalidation, naming things, and off-by-one errors. One thing is sure, C++ didn't get better at naming things, but modern C++ can help you avoid off-by-one errors. What is this? It's a classical for loop which iterates backwards through a vector v and prints out each element. So far so good, except there's a bug in it, surely you have noticed. When iterating backwards, we need to start one below the size. A classical off-by-one error. The C++ core guidelines contain a guideline that goes express intent. Say what should be done rather than just how it should be done. I told you, this is a classical for loop iterating backwards through the vector v. That's the intent, what should be done. The code, however, goes like, iterate over an integer I that starts at 1 below the size of v and decrements each iteration. Iterate as long as I is bigger or equal to 0, then print the ith element of v. That's how iteration works. Express intent means, ideally, the code should look maybe like this. That's a C++ 11 range-based for loop with the C++ 20 reverse view adapter. It indeed goes like, iterate over each element of v reversed and print it out. Once you got used to the syntax, this is much cleaner to read and it doesn't have a disposition to off-by-one errors. For demonstration, I use the open source code base of the CMake build system. It's 160,000 lines of C++ code. To show off clang-tidy, I did two modifications. Firstly, I took an almost 5-year-old revision, else there wouldn't be anything left to modernize. Secondly, I configured CMake to use the C++ 20 standard. That is, for clang-tidy to make use of C++ 20 range adapters. CMake contains thousands of for loops, some of them iterating in reversed order. Rewriting all of them manually would be a ridiculous amount of work. Luckily, the tool clang-tidy can do most of it automatically. If you don't know what clang-tidy is, check out my colleague Jesper's video on that. We will now apply clang-tidy step by step. The first step for me is to make sure the Git working tree is clean. We do need that because we'll tell clang-tidy to edit our code and Git will tell us what actually changed. It is, so the next thing we need is a compilation database. The compilation database is a file called compilecommands.json and, very roughly spoken, it's the makefile for clang-tidy. So first we need to configure the project and, luckily enough, we can build CMake using CMake. That's indeed the most comfortable situation for us, as CMake produces compilation databases as easily as it produces makefiles. If your project uses QMake or Cubes, check out Jesper's video on clang-tidy, or else check out this article on how to get a compilation database. We'll just call CMake with the command line parameter -dcmake-export-compile-commands equals on, and it'll produce the compilation database next to the makefile. If you have code generators, you might need to compile the codebase once. So, to be on the safe side, we'll quickly do that, and then we're ready to go. Clang-tidy is a collection of a multitude of independent checkers that analyze your code for common mistakes, possibilities of improvement, and so on. Some of them can automatically fix your code. We will tell clang-tidy to run exactly one check, that is, modernize-loop-convert. With the clang-tidy installation comes the binary clang-tidy and a script run-clang-tidy. We will use the latter. To run clang-tidy, I'll execute this lengthy command. you can find it in the video description to copy and paste. Now, Clang runs and compiles our code, and as you can see, it prints out a warning for every simple classical for loop it finds. And while it compiles our code, it will just rewrite them en passant. It is done, so now we run git diff and inspect all the changes. Double check if everything is correct. If run-clang-tidy produces any wrong code, I suggest you fix them now. Then do a git commit and only then apply another run-clang-tidy fix. That was easy, wasn't it? It was merely 5 steps. Make sure your git work tree is clean. Get yourself a compilation database. Run clang tidy. Use git diff to see the changes and make a commit. And finally, repeat with other clang tidy checks. Clang tidy rewrites the most basic 90% of your for loops. The remaining 10% need your manual intervention. This includes situation where you iterate over only a part of the container, over multiple containers simultaneously, or you need the index value for other matters. Clang-tidy helps you with the most tedious modernization tasks. Besides modernizing loops, there is many more checks. For example, before C++11, when you wanted to give a type an alias name, you would use typedef. With C++, you use the keyword using. Before C++11, you initialize the pointer with 0. With C++11, you use the keyword null pointer. When a class overrides a virtual function from its base class, you can safeguard it against typos with other errors with the override keyword. When a class member was to be initialized with the default value before C++11, you would do that in the constructor. With C++11, you would do that right at the member declaration. All of these and many more can be automatically modernized with run-clang-tidy. So much more to try out. Thank you for watching. To get more KDAB videos, subscribe to our channel. See you next time.